They all knew him. He was the man that cannot steer, that cannot splice, that dodges the work on dark nights, that, aloft, holds on frantically with both arms and legs and swears at the wind, the sleet, the darkness, the man who curses the sea while others work, the man who is the last out and the first in when all hands are called, the man who can't do most things and won't do the rest, the pet of philanthropists and self-seeking landlubbers, the sympathetic and deserving creature that knows all about his rights, but knows nothing of courage, of endurance, and of the unexpressed faith, of the unspoken loyalty that knits together a ship's company, the independent offspring of ignoble freedom of the slums, full of disdain and hate for the austere servitude of the sea. Someone cried at him, "What's your name?" "Donkin," he said, looking around with cheerful effrontery. "What are you?" asked another voice. "Why, a sailor, like you, old man," he replied, in a tone that meant to be hearty, but was impudent. "Blimey, if you don't look a blame sight worse than a broken-down fireman," was the comment in a convinced mutter. Charlie lifted his head and piped in a cheeky voice, "He is a man and a sailor." Then, wiping his nose with the back of his hand, bent down industriously over his bit of rope. A few laughed. Others stared doubtfully. The ragged newcomer was indignant. "That's a fine way to welcome a chap into a forecastle," he snarled. "Are you men or a lot of artless cannyballs?" "Don't take your shirt off for a word, shipmate," called out Belfast, jumping up in front, fiery, menacing, and friendly at the same time. "Is that 'ere bloke blind?" asked the indomitable scarecrow, looking right and left with affected surprise. "Can't ye see I 'aven't got no shirt?" He held both his arms out crossways and shook the rags that hung over his bones with dramatic effect. "'Cause why?" he continued very loud. "The bloody Yankees been trying to jump my guts out 'cause I stood up for my rights like a good 'un. I am an Englishman, I am. They set upon me, and I 'ad to run. That's why. Ain't you never seed a man 'ard up?" "Yeah. What kind of blame ship is this?" "I'm dead broke. I 'aven't got nothink. No bag, no bed, no blanket, no shirt. Not a bloomin' rag but what I stand in. But I 'ad the 'art to stand up agin them Yankees. Has any of you 'art enough to spare a pair of old pants for a chum?" He knew how to conquer the naive instincts of that crowd. In a moment they gave him their compassion, jocularly, contemptuously, or surlily, and at first it took the shape of a blanket thrown at him as he stood there with the white skin of his limbs showing his human kinship through the black fantasy of his rags.